Styles. Roll TV.
And when you were growing up, you said you started at an early age right out of high school, but you've probably always been rapping and stuff like that. What made you not want to rap about, like girls and jewelry and bling? And I mean, like, if you listen to your lyrics, I mean, like for real, like, half the stuff that rappers are coming out with nowadays is talking about my Escalade. I mean, what? you make it deeper. You, Kanye, Common. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody here from Chicago. Is you think it's a different boundary or something? Or you think, what do you think it basically is that you guys talk about more stuff like knowledge stuff?
Well, initially I did, to be honest, you know what I'm saying? And I had it, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? I had my first record there. I had two diamond chains and diamond bracelets and Rolexes and mules, honestly. Because to me, that was success, mm-hmm. you know? And then what started to happen, the material success started to wear off. You know, it started for me, it didn't mean anything. I knew that what I was saying didn't really have any, it didn't mean anything. Mm-hmm. And then when I did a song called Could Have Been, right? Okay. Which is probably like one of the first songs I did that had a real positive message. And it was just like 60-year-old ladies would walk up to me and be like, I really like that song.
Oh, okay.
And I started, and it was real. You know,
like,
it
was a daughter?
A granddaughter?
It was real, though, because it wasn't forced. You know, it came from my background. My mother's an intellectual. My father, rest in peace. He was a Renaissance man, engineer, you know, karate instructor, the whole thing. So I just was like, you know, Let me talk about some of the weirder stuff, the more stuff that's to the left, the stuff that's a little bit more positive.
Because you stand out more now.
Yeah, even standing out, I'm doing something good.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I know that I'm affecting somebody when I do songs like He Say, She Say, mm-hmm. as opposed to if I did a song where I'm like, yo, shoot him up in a club.
Yeah,
shoot
him
up in a club. You know, it reverberates.
Which has been done
more.
47 times.
Exactly.
And since this morning.
And, yeah, well, you know.
All right, so the album is out in stores right now.
As a matter of fact,
cool.
Shoot him up in the club. Let me write that down.
Yeah, write
that
down.
Yeah. There's been a couple of remixes as well. I already thought of.
Yeah, cool is in stores right now. Yeah, man. Yeah.
Superstar, man. Now, who? Matthew Santos.
Matthew Santos.
Now, is that your boy, or did you discover him, or is
he's,
he just
Matthew Santos? We actually worked out of the same studio on the North Side. Mm-hmm. Shout out to my man G Ball, big Cubs fan.
Yeah. Nice, smart guy.
We I met him in the studio, and he's actually on my first album, a song called American Terrorist. And on this album, I knew I wanted to work with him again. Like, he's such a phenomenal talent. Chicago-based.
Mm-hmm.
Originally,
cool.
Originally from
cool.
Minneapolis, but Chicago-based. Mm-hmm. Been around the city doing mad shows for a couple years now. Phenomenal guy. Filipino. Mad talented. Cool. Very dope.
Yeah, his voice is just like...
It sounds like, I mean, like, an alternative group or something like that. Like, I've already heard
maybe
before.
Like a Maroon 5 type. Like a One Republic kind of, like,
and
you know,
so
like, join on there.
It's so great that it's not one of those guys, that it's your own guy. That's really, really cool, I think. Yeah, that's
he's
really cool.
First and 15th, my company, First and 15th's own.
Nice.
He has mad range. He sounds like that because I wrote it like that.
Oh, really?
You know what I'm saying? But he really does, his heart is like in folk music.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But his range is he can do anything.
Yeah.
And that's what's amazing about him.
And speaking of range, we can do anything. Let's talk about this real quick. Yourself, Pharrell, and Kanye West. Everybody's talking about some super group. Now, you guys kind of have a name of it. Is there going to be an album? Are you going to be in the studio doing some
is
stuff with
this? Is
this
for real? This happening?
It's for real.
Really?
It's a real thing.
Now, this what's up. Now, that's high right there.
It's a real thing. I was talking to Kanye yesterday about it, and we're just gearing up to actually how to do it. You know, mm-hmm. we know if we just came out and did something, it's going to be crazy, mm-hmm. but we want to make it last. We want to make
Hell
an impact.
Yeah.
We want to do like some Led Zeppelin,
that's
you
cool,
know what I'm saying,
man.
Crazy Pink Floyd kind of situation. But it's coming.
That's cool.
Child Rebel Soldiers.
When are we thinking? Like a couple years down the road? We thinking like
tomorrow? No. We thinking like late 08.
Okay, really?
You know what I'm saying? We thinking like hit the momentum.
Yeah.
We did one song called Us Places with Tom York.
Right.
And it's actually a video. You can check it out on YouTube right now.
Cool.
It's just you just search Us Places Tom York video and it'll be on there.
That's awesome,
craziness,
man. I mean, a lot of supergroups happen that I'm like, I don't really care about that supergroup, but this is a supergroup that I really want to like be a part of that movement. That's really cool. I'm really excited to hear what's going to happen.
You can see like Common calling you, yo, can I get in?
Am I not? Twister, like, what the hell, man? I'm in a supergroup.
But you know what? I know you're a really busy guy, man. We appreciate you running through. One more question for you real quick.
Yeah.
Every artist has a writer. All right, and for you listening at home, a writer is like what the artist would like in their dressing room or their appearance, stuff like that. You have M&Ms, but specifically just
yellow M&Ms.
You don't like the other colors of the M&Ms?
Nah, I don't like
that. That's
other
racist,
colors.
Man. That's racist.
You know.
What is there about the other M&Ms, the other colors, that doesn't fit with you?
I don't eat the dyes.
Okay.
Is that what it is?
I don't eat the dyes.
Is that bad for you?
It's just a preference.
Doesn't yellow have a dye though to it? Or
yeah,
no?
Yeah. It's certain dyes like red 40. I don't mess with another thing.
So yellow dye is cool with you.
Yellow dye number 5 is my jump.
All right.
I wish I could be painted yellow dye number 5.
Man, again, too deep for me, man. Lupe Fiasco, Chicago's very
yes,
own.
Yeah,
we're
yeah.
in Roman at B96.
Go get the album in stores.
Yeah.
B96.